Wow. There's an attack helicopter right above my head. Well, it's, what is this? Episode 4 now? Day 4, technically, for us. Welcome back, everybody. I'm Jade Monkey. We're back here in Rust, Rust Console Edition. And we are doing our solo series again. As I said earlier, this is episode 4. I don't know if we're going by days or not, but, yeah, this is, the life of a solo. We got raided. It was a little crazy. If you want to get started at the beginning of this series, I guess I'll go ahead. Yeah, it would make sense for me to go ahead and link it now in the upper right-hand corner. Do-do-do-do. To give a little recap, on the last one, we had gotten raided, well, about two episodes ago, we got raided, and then we were able to put this down. And surprisingly enough, we're still up and running here. Ooh, a little spurt of lag. So we're going to see how far we can take. Oh my goodness, this guy get bigger again? Wow, okay. This is the first time I've signed in a few days. So you can see my upkeep's about 14 days. So let me give a little... So yeah, we're trying to build up here. We're trying to at least get a foothold. We've got the garage door learned, as you know, from the previous one, which has been great. I think what we'll try to do... And let me know if you like this or not down in the comments. I think when I'm farming, if I'm talking, I think I'll leave it in. And then if there's like a gap there, I will jump it. I'll cut it. But for you guys, it'll be a jump. Let me know if you like it. If you don't like it, it's entirely up to you. Okay, so what I have been doing periodically is I go through and I will sign in just inside of the airlock here and then burn some of the metal, which you can see. We almost have 2K, which is really, really great. It's actually a lot more than I thought we had. So, yeah, we're looking good. Okay, so the game plan today is to get this to a 2x2 status, possibly some honeycombs. We're going to be doing lots of farming. We do have to nail some of these better BPs down, such as the metal pick, metal hatchet. If I have enough resources, I would love... Ooh. I would love... Look at this. Oh, hang on. I would love... Oh, okay, that's a turret. Never mind. Just kidding. I would love to get a jackhammer. Man, this guy got big, right? Wow. Okay, let's take a little gander around. And here's the other goal. Ooh, got some bigger neighbors. We might get might be getting raided in a few days. The goal here is not only to learn as much as we can, but I'd like to have the base in such a place where we can just log in and start doing some crazy plays, because I want to, you know, dial up some of the PvP I got going on and really feel it out with the old controller, you know what I mean? I mean, I think we get a lot of experience playing with the group on the other server, but it'd be fun to kind of dial it in a little bit, kind of like our combat arenas, but, you know, the real deal on a live server. If you ever saw our combat arenas. Ooh, by the way, I should put this out there. As soon as the custom servers come online, I'm just kind of checking the area, we will be doing the boyfriend squad. We will be doing our own custom servers. We'll have one that's more event-driven for everybody to join, and we'll also have another that is a slightly tweaked official or vanilla flavor of Rust, if that makes sense. Like, just slightly boosted rates, maybe, to encourage raiding or building or something like that. Nothing game-breaking. I'm very much about keeping balance in the game. So if there are some tweaks, they're going to be relatively minor. So if anybody wants to kind of jump in, well, so we'll hopefully make it fun for everybody. So yeah, that'll be going on whenever those come online. As of recording this, I don't have any information on that yet. But as soon as we do, be rest assured that we will, all three of us, let you know, the Boyfriend Squad, Razor2, BioLaser, and myself, Jade Monkey, we will tell you, man. We're really excited for it. And here's the other thing. It's going to be open to everybody, but I think while we're setting them up, what we've done in the past is we've... Oh, dude, I got a lot more picks than I thought. Well, what we've done in the past is people that are members to our channels will give access to the servers like a week or two in advance, and then it will be open to everybody else. Just, yeah, like a thank you for the people that have been there to support everything. And then, you know, it's not like, even if you're not a supporter, you'll still be able to play. It's just kind of a thing to kind of help us get set up. And again, a thank you for those people that are members to the channel. So thank you very much. And thank you to everybody that is around helping us, being a part of it, whether it be in the chat, our community, whatever. It's always greatly appreciated, and it's a good time. So we appreciate that. Anyways, all right, so let's get into it. So game plan is to get enough supplies for our base here. I was doing like five things at once while I was talking to you guys. Like I said, I've only signed in enough to really look at this and go, huh. We don't have a hatchet yet either, do we? Okay, so... Oh, we're just shy of that, aren't we? Okay, well, let's go try to get some Scrap. I'm gonna take the whole payload with us. Oh wait, can we just recycle something? Ooh, we totally can. Let's recycle that. We'll take half of these against my better judgment. Cause you know we may or may not be around long enough. Last time we got raided pretty quick. So yeah, I would love to get a metal hatchet going. That would be great. Actually, let me go check my... Maybe I learned it. Oh, wait. Let me go back here. Sorry, I'm all over the place. Dude, I'm so excited to be playing this, though. Hey, let me ask you this. One more question. Anybody who's been playing, is this game getting a hold of you or what? When you first started playing, did it grab you and when? At what point? Like, how far into you playing? I'm interested to know because so many people are like, dude, once I got into this, it was over. It's like, I believe it. Oh, I did learn it. Okay, perfect. Okay, well, let's just go make some at the outpost. We got a dirty burp. Okay. All right, let's focus here. I'm all over the place. I'm like, dude, I can't wait to add to the base. I love the building in this game. It's fantastic. Okay, so we're going to go make one and then hopefully learn one of these after we've used it a little bit. Although we have two, so we can sacrifice it. So yeah, let's do that. I kind of lost my train of thought on what else I was talking about, but that's okay. That's okay. All right, so we're going to take some metal fragments with us. Oh, that's perfect. Oh, yeah, I was going to go over what happened. So while I was out here, I don't know, this was more than a handful of days ago. I caught a dude with his bag. Do you know what I'm talking about? Outside the outpost, he had gotten clapped. And so I looked in front of him, and he had this pistol. So we do have to learn this as well. Ooh, better question. Do we learn this first or the other one? All right, since we have two picks, hopefully I'm not jumping around too much. I'm all over the place, dude. I'm so excited for this. I love early game. I love building. I love the whole process of this game. That's what I'm saying. Like, so many people are like, hey, I don't know about the wipe system. Tell me, hasn't it been good? Don't you love it? Okay, so let's go to the outpost and get this cashed out. Hopefully I can get my thoughts in order here. I love loot. I love stacking it. It feels so good. So yeah, this has been about a week and change, I think, since full release. We've been doing, I think, three different series. We've been doing a big group, we've been doing a duo, and the solo I'm doing, obviously, by myself. But, man, we've been having a blast the whole time. We've gotten big on the other server, and RazorTube and I are doing a duo. Hopefully, if we can get our timing right, we're going to have all three of us, the Boyfriend Squad, BioLaser, RazorTube, myself, doing a trio, which would be great. Mad excited for that. I think we just got a couple new servers and stuff. Online, I think we've got weeklies. Oh, yeah, if you didn't know. If you're looking for crossplay servers, they're supposed to all be officials, but the filtering is kind of messed up, so they brought them online a little bit later. Maybe you already know this. I'm sorry if you do. Just look for where it says, like, monthly or weekly. It'll say CP in those brackets. That's how you know it's crossplay, so... Oh, this guy's using a recycler. All right, that's fine. Let's go over here and use this. Again, the outpost being OP. So I don't know. I guess we're trying to do this like day by day in game because it gives us the most daylight. So we'll see how well that works for us. Still trying to feel it out. Who else is excited for that skin store, man? Woo! All right, let's go try to hit some barrels while we're waiting for this. Okay. Rewinding back to our goals, we're definitely going to be adding to the base and getting it stable enough so we can roam a little bit. So we'll need plenty of wood and stone. I think we have an okay start on wood. Stone wouldn't be bad for us to get. So we'll kind of skim the area while we're waiting for the recycler. Because I definitely don't want to be risking all of my scraps. And my thought is I'll kind of back down into it. Remember these dudes that raided us? I'm guessing their base is so big it might collapse here pretty soon, but I definitely want to give them a taste of some solo clapback if we have a chance. So we'll see what that looks like. Let's go ahead and grab some more of this right quick. Oh, man. So excited. I love this game, dude. We've been playing this so long on PC, and we've been waiting for it so long for it to come to console. It's just so nice to actually be playing it. And I got to tell you, and again, depending on when you watch this, because usually these are... more than a handful of days ahead of time. I'm hoping that our 103 comes in soon, at least as of recording this. We don't necessarily know when yet, but I know we've gotten like freezes and stuff and like there's some crashing issues, but hopefully those will be nice and repaired soon enough. I mean, oh, speaking of freezes, there's one. But you know what, to be fair, like I do like the fact that they're pushing and making this like a priority, and they're constantly going to be on this. Like the game plan isn't like, oh, we'll release it, we'll give us some support, and then see where it's at. Like their game plan is to fully stay on this and keep adding those features as it moves forward, which I am very excited for. I mean, this basically feels like a face punch setup. You know what I mean? The people that originally did this, but I don't know. It's just me rambling about it. It's exciting. Because even with the glitches and stuff, like the hiccups, this game is still a blast. You know, like you hear me say it all the time, but it's true. I mean, you see us. How many different streams have we done with crazy amounts of time? And it feels like it's like 30 minutes. It's beautiful. I love it. It's not to say that Rust doesn't have its stripe. It does. As far as, you know, like the soul life. I mean, look, shoot. We're doing this series, and I got raided on day two, you know? Badly. Like, not only did they raid me, they hollowed me out and put a door on. But, I mean, that's kind of the ebb and flow of it, right? It's the high risk, high reward. Sorry, I know we're farming stones with a rock. It's rough. It's rough, baby. It's rough. Alright, so once we get some supplies and expand the base a little bit, we'll try to make some basic. Oops. Weapons? So we can start doing things like the airfield. We should probably do the dish monument a few times too. I mean, we have enough to go run it. My goal for this series was to kind of show you what it's like to go solo, that, you know, and try to leave in all the good and bad stuff. Because a lot of people are like, oh, I mean, like the montages or the stories are great, don't get me wrong. But a lot of people are like, hey man, I'm struggling. I was like, here, I'll show you what the struggle is. I'll show you how bad I get beat up. I'll show you missing left and right. Yeah! Let's go check that recycler. Alright, so I'm kind of thinking in my head. I know, this is like free-form thought for me, so I got like a million things going on at once. That's just kind of how I operate. Hopefully, it's not too much. I'm thinking about the base. So, one of the key tenets of staying alive, I think, that's been my experience for forever, is keeping it low key enough. If you put a lot of stuff on or get too big or you're looking metal on the exterior, you have a tendency to have people pull in and want to clap your cheeks. You look juicy enough to raid. So, I think it was a Razor, it was a Bilege that said it's a fine line between looking too rich or looking too poor or just poor enough, if that makes sense. Is this guy back in the recycler? But yeah, I think that's very, very true. The this guy must be trying to get something. All right, fine. We'll go farm again. Fine, dude. So I'm thinking to go back to what I was thinking. As far as the base expansion is concerned, it's like, do I go 2x2? Do I put some honeycomb on? I gotta remember, I'm not with anybody else. So I gotta be careful about how I expand, like as a solo. It's tricky because it's easy to go big, and then as you sign out, you're like, oh, I need to, like, the upkeep becomes a lot after you reach a certain size, which is by design. Oh yeah, give me some of that. Oh, what? We just got the window, babe, dude. We're going back for that. Now we have to get 75. Priorities have shifted. Oh my goodness, dude. We got the garage door, and then those are like the biggest building blocks, I think, right up next to the armored doors and such. My goodness, we got the glass window. We're good. We're rich. See what we can get under our belt here. Any more of these? All right, making sure I'm not taking rads. I don't know about you, but I'm used to hearing the tick sound when there's rad damage, and not hearing it here really throws me off. I'll be looking down, and then I'll have like 50 rad damage, and I'm just like, hey, that's a lot. I didn't know that. No kidding. I only dump these. Oh, that bear's guarding that spot. What a douche. Oh, we have 81. Okay. The pistol's good, but here's the thing. Kind of thinking. The original plan was to do the pistol or the pick. But now that we have this building block, which is the glass window, which can be difficult to get, I think we'll learn that first, which should be 75 and a workbench level 1. Here's what I'm thinking. Because of that, if we somehow get raided again, knock on wood, I hope that doesn't happen. If we get raided one more time, hopefully I have the ability, or I will have the ability to come out here and buy another revolver if I need to. That's not the game plan, but I figured this is more rare because sometimes you don't even find these. So this is gonna be a big boon to my production because this is essentially a very cheap not armored door, it's a very cheap roller door, is what this turns into. And since it is just me, it's a lot easier to manage. Don't have to worry about authorization because if I built it, I'm authorized. So now we have 6 left over. That one dude hopefully is done recycling. All he's doing is going back and forth nonstop. He's probably still recycling. We can go back to base and drop some of this off then. Oh, thank goodness. Does anybody else find it annoying when people jump on your head when you're recycling? I do. I find it terribly annoying. Oh, here's what I did. I thought I brought the pistol with me. I ejected the rounds. Man. Well, again, a little tip. A lot of times when I'm tight on scrap, I will not research the bullet, and then I'll just build the weapon and then eject the round. Oh, dude, we're awfully close to 75, aren't we? All right, let's go bank a little bit, because I'm feeling like we're carrying a pretty big payload, playing it very conservative. Because, again, I'm all about pushing that research, because I'm doing this solo series in chunks. So I may be on for a few days, but I may be off for a few days. I mean, I'll come in and, like, load up the furnace, but for the most part, I need to make sure I'm planning for the worst, is what I'm saying. Gotta make sure we're good in that department. Oh, dude, there's so much loot. I love hitting barrels. It's the best. I'm excited to see that power surge update and, like, more specifically, what's in it. Anybody else? Anybody? In the comments? Anyone? I'm very excited for it. If it brings in the level of electricity that I think it's going to, and again, we don't know officially yet, that would be amazing. I cannot tell you what kind of awesome gameplay loop that's going to bring in. Okay, I must have already learned that. Yeah, this desert's rough. Tell you what, this guy right here, I believe he's a solo because I saw wooden locks on his stuff. He has built up a beefy boy. He's going deep. Is that a level 3 up there too? My goodness. He's got a little perch. See, you can totally go solo in this game. That's crazy. Well, congrats to him. 2-layer walls. Spikes everywhere. That's impressive. Impressive. Or I guess what we could do with this base, we could do a 2x3, but I don't know if I have enough resource to pull that. We kind of have to see what like an average day will bring us as far as resources are concerned. Ooh, we got the crude. We'll mess with that here in a little bit. We got, man, I can't believe we found that glass window. That's amazing. So pumped out of my mind. Out of my mind. We're getting some more gears, so we're looking good. Look at that. We almost have 2.2, 2.3K. Dang. Alright, so what? We need 200 for this? Trying to find the notch on the picture that makes it look or that's exactly where 2/3 is. Or 1/3, rather. Or is it 2/3? Yeah, it's 1/3. We're getting there. Oh, did this burn out okay already? Man, for one furnace? Not too bad. But just to show you that, not only can you do solo, you can do solo and have your fingers in multiple wipes if you really want to. Quite that much. Stick the rest here. Yeah, I don't want to burn too much of my wood. We're already getting a lot of charcoal. Surprise. I was just thinking to myself, I've already got that. And I'm like, no, that's on the other server. So we don't. I am kind of inching towards recycling some of these right away, just because the likelihood of me getting raided is also very high. And I want to be able to learn as much as I can. You know what? I'm gonna burn up one of these. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. No, I'm not. We'd like to learn this as well. Alright, let's go do more. Hey, I thought we were going to be doing lots of farming. But it looks like we're just being scrubs. I mean, we are farming, but this isn't very... What's the word? Base farmy? Base farming? I don't want that heat, Mr. Wolf. I wonder if we should just skip and go to the big boy pick. I think it's a level 2, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know, I keep getting fused because 2018 Rust, which is the Rust we're in, it's like a hybrid. And then I'm thinking of 2021 Rust on PC, and I can't remember exactly what workbench that's on because there was a balance pass semi-recently. I want to say in the last 8 or 6 months, if my memory serves me correctly. That's okay. I just want to add to the base, man. I see loot and I want to grab it. Is that bad? Hey, I'm going to check the map to see what's in this. Metal ore for 300. Red key card and explosive ammo. I mean, that's a bit advanced for us. Don't. Are not in that range yet. We definitely can be, but we're not right now. Double barrel for 375. Water pipe for 325. Beautiful. Yeah, that other store we were looking at, since it's been so many days, definitely got raided. Or it decayed, or both. Who knows? Is there a scientist walking around this thing? Why do I feel like he's in the pole and he's gonna shoot me? Yes. Am I cheap? I just want to break my rock. Am I a piece of trash? What time is it in game? It's 2 p.m. Okay, we still got some more time. Hey, it's slow going sometimes, but you gotta take what you can get. Ooh, I see a propane tank. Don't roll towards it. I need everything I can get. Yes, and my game plan is also to be recycling things like carpets and extra sewing kits for the rope. Although, to be fair, until the farming comes in, it's a bit... I don't want to say broken, but it's much easier to do food and cloth. It's not so much of a problem, but I'm so used to the new way for PC Rust. This is 2021 Rust, where you have to really be conservative and then plan your farming to both have cloth and for your food. But food is pretty plentiful here, so I guess I just need to let it go. I just need to let it go. I just farm this. Here, let's grab a couple of these while we're chilling here, right? I mean, these trees are... Oh, that's right. That's probably why people haven't done it. This guy's on my face. Palm trees are cool, but I tell you what, they definitely create a spot for people to jump up in, right? Anyways, I'm looking forward to those new changes. The agricultural stuff was most likely going to be in relatively soon. That's my guess. But it definitely changes the game. You wouldn't think so, even if you're not into the agricultural stuff, the farming. But it definitely changes the way you do lots of things. The T's are pretty nice. Those are crazy buffs that I think people don't use enough on PC. They're very, very good. I don't know, it just changed a lot of the game. It makes the bases slightly different because you need like an agricultural section or two. It's beautiful. You'll like it. You'll see. Come on, have we steered you wrong so far? We told you it'd be good. We told you. Oh, wait, no, we'll have enough for this, won't we? Hang on, let me do my auto run and then. Don't you hate that where you think you got it long enough? There it goes. Oh, we already have enough. Alright, we'll learn the pistol. Revolver. It's gonna be key. Let's see what else we can get here. We might as well finish up our little round. Oh, man, I'm excited to do the base building stuff on this one, dude. I still don't know how we're gonna do that base. So we got 2x3? So we got 2x2? I just don't know! I better go get that first. Somebody else grabs it. I was also thinking about my settings. I think I've got a good baseline, but I think I'm ready to make some adjustments, and then I'm going to need to have some time to really let those settle in. Because it's not enough to just make the tweaks. You got to play with it for a while for it to really, you know? I think. This game is good at enticing you. Oh, okay, so the other game plan... Oh, man. I guess we'll make another rock. The other game plan is to have another small base by someplace like Bandit Camp / the Dome. As we can do... Well, A, it's going to spread us out, which is perfect. Also, the cost for upkeep is going to be lower doing something like that. It protects us twice as much. It doesn't cost as much for upkeep. And we'll be able to kind of move around a bit more. And it's a bit more incognito. So there's a lot of benefits to it. So if we can add on to our base a little bit, and then maybe put down the other base, but I don't know if that'll be for this session completely, because I think the sun is going down. Man, I thought we'd be able to get to more of that. Probably try to farm through the night and stuff. I'll probably skip jump that because it's so dark. But, I don't know, we'll see. I wasn't expecting us to do this much scrapping, but... Hey, we got a window and we got that pistol. I kind of forgot that we got that, right? Hey, think about it. If we didn't research that garage door, we would have been behind. Did I learn that? I guess I did. That water jug, by the way, speaking of agricultural and farming, man, that's one you want to get. Well, you actually just get the item if it's later, but that little jug thing is so OP because you have dew collectors on top, and then you're transferring stuff through containers and then putting it in that bigger jug. And then once the water piping comes online, you have it automatically go down. Then it's like a good way to grow your crops because like clean water becomes like a very valuable resource later on. It's just, the game loops are so good in this. I can't wait for that to come back online, but I am mad excited for this electricity. I'm excited. Can you tell? What, does this guy have his back? Oh, I thought it looked like a SAR for a second. I mean, the wife's been going on long enough. It wouldn't surprise me, but I was like, can I steal it? I thought it always goes through your head when you're jumping around. I don't think we're going to have road sign for a little bit, so I'm a little... Ah, man, I'm like on the fence whether or not to recycle that. Hey, if we get 150? Ooh, we might be able to get the bullet, too. Hold on. The reason why this is so important is this is a projectile weapon, but... Lots of weapons convert well with pistol bullets as you start to go up. But more importantly, we're going to be stuck in tier 1 for a minute. So think about that. Like, the pistol and the revolver are both in that tier 1 section. So, like, I can very easily make a level 1 workbench or come here and craft a pistol and, like, do some work with it. Like, yes, it's lower powered. But again, it's about situational stuff in this game. So what I'm saying basically is I think I can do a lot with it if I need to. Because, again, I'm expecting to get raided almost every time I sign in. Remember, I don't have a team to lean on to, like, help, A, look over the base, but also farm and, you know. If we're going to have enough. See, level 1 workbench, baby. Oh, that's good. I didn't think we'd get this much going on. Woo! Like I said, if it gets dark, I'll farm through the night. I'll probably jump skip that unless something crazy happens. And then we'll try to build the next day if that happens. But this was too important to not do. Dude, look at this. We got 109.556. I'm not going to learn that. We don't have any weapons that can shoot it. And most of those weapons, if not all of them, I believe, are under the guise of Workbench 2. Guys, would that be right? Hang on. Define the word guise.
Guise means an external form, appearance, or manner of presentation, typically concealing the true nature of something.
So I use that incorrectly. That's more deception. Never mind. It's like, I don't think I used that right. Siri? She told me what's up. I don't know if you guys could hear that, but... Okay. Oh, you know what else is really OP? These are 20, I think. Let's go check. Whew, this is supposed to be a build episode, but we're like scrappy scrap, and I'm pumped out of my mind for this. I am looking forward to that Duos Heroes 2 and the Trio once we get all the boys timing. Yeah, let's see if we can farm. We can farm 20 scrap. Come on, we're not scrubs. Another thing that just kind of popped into my head that it's definitely a smart thing to do for any player, whether you're group, duo, or trio, is to do those little custom shops. And for us, wouldn't be terribly bad because we have times in between. Maybe do a little sulfur shop? Not a bad idea. Do we have a pistol? We have the rounds. Oh, yes, yes, fight each other. Yes, pull away, please, please, please. Oh, yeah. This should give us what we need. 20 scrap is nothing. Oh, I see a crate. And we can start running around. I really want to be running around, like, in the next few episodes. Like, we'll be doing building, of course. I love it. But I really want to be skeezing and dipping on people. The bow fighting feels good in this game. So that's a crossbow. Anyways, I don't know if I said this earlier, or I think I started the thought and then I jumped, but I'm pretty excited for that skin store. I am. I have so many skins on PC, and that's just me. Like, I love skins in a game I play a lot, especially like an open world survival. That's just me. But yeah, I can't wait to get my dirty little fingers on that stuff. I'll get another barrel. Ooh, we got 11. I think the sheet metal will give us 8 or 5. It's not a round number like 10. Big round number. We got here, scrappy doodles. Let's go hit this one, see what we got, and then we'll see if we can't learn that sucker. Yeah, we're pretty close. I think I already learned that. I did. I'm going to throw it on the ground. By the way, fun little trick you can do. If you know someone's going to raid you, save up a bunch of those poopy VPs and just spread them out in a box. And leave a note. This is IOU loot. It's a good... Holy. Gears. Oh, that's a bear. No thanks. No thanks, no thanks. Please don't aggro. Please don't aggro. Wow, dude, why did he get over there? I can't wait for the outpost update where they're more passive. They'll attack you if you hit them, but they won't, like, chase you. Anyways, has anybody had the problem where people bait a bear to the front gate and just let it chill? I love the skanky ingenuity that people come up with in this game. It never ceases to amaze. And I've been playing this game for 7 years. I love it. Okay, we'll learn that flame arrow. We're good to go. Looks like we'll do a little night farming. Most likely off camera. Well, it's on camera. We'll probably just jump it because it's going to be so dark. I'll try to add to that base. Still have daylight, man. Okay, there it is. The beautiful flame arrow. What am I doing? That still gets me. Every time the cursor moves up. Every time. Flame arrows are OP, if you didn't know. Very, very OP. If you're still primitive and you want to get some geared players, pin them in and get some nice AoE. Flame arrows are where it's at. If you've seen the combat arena that we've done, we do specific rounds that are no flame arrows because they're so OP. They're good. They're really good. Okay, so we've got a lot of scrap done so far. We've got the revolver, the pistol. We've got the hatchet that was already done previously. I got the glass window. We've got the flame arrows. Whew, dude. We're sitting pretty. Yeah, we're most likely going to go into the next day with this one. Because we got to add to the base. We got to. That guy's gotten bigger. I don't know if those are two buildings or if that's just one weird lopsided building. It looks like they're interconnected. Maybe not. They have to be or the other one's going to decay. That's really weird. Well, whatever. Back to our humble abode. If I was getting more resources... I would think about doing a 2x3 because it's definitely beefy. But it is a bit more target rich. We'll wait and see. I don't know yet. I'm all over the place. I mean, we have good resource. Is this wood? No, stone. Okay, good. I'm going to have to turn up my brightness again. Sorry. It might be a little crazy. Wait, that's not where brightness is. What am I doing? Right, box, box. That's what I'm trying to make. probably do a couple. Supply box. Oh yeah, I think we can only fit one. That's fine. Pretty sure we can fit it back like this. About to find out. Yeah, we need more protection. We definitely need more room. I'm hoping we can satisfy both of those conditions. This is probably where we're going to be doing some jumping as far as for you guys. I'll be cutting it, so it'll be jumps. But the idea is I'll farm and then have hopefully enough resources to add on to this, and then that'll be the part that you guys get to see. Unless somebody shoots me out in the wild, and then you guys will definitely see that. Yes, I knew I could feed it. More beautiful space! Did I already put a rug in here? Oh, I did. Totally did. Let's do it like this, dude. Put two down. Nothing sticking out, looking good. Also very dark. Operation farm a lot. I should grind you up. Dang, we got 6 gears. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go to the outpost and make some garage doors. I gotta tell ya, it is so nice to not get stream sniped while we're playing. It's beautiful. That'll be 3, and that'll be 900. Ooh, just under. I would just take 1,000. Wait, if we bring some wood? Hold on. Oh yeah! We could also make a revolver too! Alright, well you're not doing farming yet. Come on, Jade, just farm, dude! Run it back. I lied! We're doing more! Yes! I don't know, that loot cycle, the progression, it always feels great. I love it. Fun fact, I've never played Subnautica. I think I might try it out here in the next couple days. I heard it's on the Switch. Might have to check it out during a forced family outing. Okay, I'm probably gonna recycle the flame turret because I don't. They got better later, I think. So we don't really utilize them. I'm probably not going to at all. Plus that GFX glitch really makes it stand out. So there's really no surprise to it, in my opinion. For now. Oh man, we got gears on that roll? Oh my goodness, we're rich! Oh my. Yeah, I pretty much just recycle propane tanks. And if I get and learn a flamethrower, I end up just repairing it. I very rarely make one, but I don't know. That's just me. What are we doing again? Oh yeah, pistol. I have to be careful that doesn't land in my main inventory, so let me go ahead and prevent that now. Yes, if that drops in and you're not paying attention, you're in this menu, you're gonna get shot. What else am I doing? Garage door. Gotta remember, since I'm solo, I just need to do woodlocks. Unless I'm trying to fake people out. Make them think that I'm a group, but Oh, I definitely don't want to do that. I can make 3 garage doors as a solo. Get out of here. We're rich. Rich! I feel like I just made out like a bandit. Using the outpost stuff. I think the guy straight north has done it right. He is definitely a solo. Last time I checked. And he's bulked up pretty good. He's very turtly.
Turtles. Very beautiful little turtles.
Alright, we'll go check our wood and stone quantities, and we'll see what we can get in the middle of the night. And then I'll shut up for a little bit while I farm, so we can jump cut. Yeah, look at that and go, 2x3? 2x2? I don't know. How about you? Garage doors. Yeah. Ooh. Rich. We could do some building now-ish. Alright, we need a little bit more wood, maybe another 2 or 3K, and as much stone as we can get. I think that's a fair assessment. So let's go get the boring trees, I guess. Pretty much just gonna strip down. I save everything. I'm still making garage doors, hang on. Definitely don't want to be giving those up. Got 9 more seconds. Watch me end up talking the whole way all night. People be like, I thought you were gonna jump cut. And I'd be like, man, I couldn't shut up. Yeah, I've noticed the voice chats come and went. So it's, hopefully it's back online. There's been just crazy numbers, like the last week or so. We can change. Is it almost daylight again? It is. I did talk to the entire night. Okay, I think in my head, I know what we're going to add to the exterior. How much do we have? Not even 1,000. Yeah, because we need to get this particular episode under control. I think we've almost done an hour. It's kind of crazy. Yeah, you really don't notice how much, like, because it feels like a little bit of time, but like, when you're keeping track of like episodes and timing, you really start to feel how much time slips by when you play this game, which is a good thing, but you're just like, what? Should we get some sulfur? Yeah. We are rich enough. I can't see the sparkle, so it's making this a little oh, there we go. At least it's difficult. Man, I want a jackhammer so bad. Hey, at the rate we're getting scrap, maybe we can just do it whenever. We're almost at that point. I feel we can do it. Let's go over here. There's more nodes. If it's daybreak, I still think we can add to it. So if we have an extra floor, is that like 300, 306? Then we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times 3, 12. So 6, 12, 1800. Almost 2K. If the math is right, I'm flying a little loosey-goosey on the math. Dude, I did talk through the entire night. What a douche. Hey, you gotta do what you gotta do when you're doing solo, man. What we say, as much stone as we can get. If we can get 2 or 3K, I think we'll be good. And then we'll get our building addition, and then we'll call it a wrap on episode 4? Is that the one we're shooting today? Not to do it. Man, I really want to get that. also really want to get this. Need stone first. Stone, stone, stone. It's like somebody else was getting the stone. Don't know where the twinkle is. There you are. Good guess. Get it. Get it. You get like another node. Maybe that metal node, then we'll build it. Maybe the sulfur node too. I love this game. I can't stop. It's pretty obvious that first week it came out, which we knew was gonna happen. But I was playing so hard. And then I crashed, and then I would play hard, and then I crashed, and then I'd play hard. And then I'm like, oh, I forgot to schedule my video. Is that it for the nodes? Oh, wait, I gotta turn this down. This is, like, crazy bright. Sorry. With the fog, it makes it extra obnoxious. Is that better? The morning mist. Yeah, watch. I told you. We probably won't have any cuts. Come on, there's got to be something here. Ooh, that's too good to pass up, but I need the stone. Where are you? Yeah, jackhammer life. I think once we have this set and we've got some good roaming stuff for, like, primitive... doing monuments and stuff, I think we're going to be in a really good place. And we'll have enough scrap to get a jackhammer, and then that jackhammer will help us get some more materials for the base. I almost always want to start farming with the jackhammer right away, so if it gets stolen, I want to get a few payloads of work done with it first before it gets... because it's 150 scrap, you know? Yeah, dude. Alright, well, we'll get the metal node... the sulfur node, and we'll head back, I guess. Oh, is that stone? Yes. Yes, it is. Where's that twinkle, dude? Is it a tiny twinkle? It's not showing up yet. Come on. We could already be done with the jackhammer. And again, if we're doing a lot of monuments and stuff, there's a chance we might get some jackhammers off of players, or... drop. Finish him. I'll get all the notes right next to your base. Watch me. Oh, there's that metal node. I want it. Twinkles haven't shown up yet. I'm gonna guess where the critical is. On the hump? Is it on the bump? Oh, I missed it when it flashed. Gotta get out of here. If someone's in this base, they'd be coming out hitting me too. Since these are all basically the same map for a good vast majority of these, I keep thinking there's like a set of dudes over here, like right at 150, but there's not because that's on the other server. Freaking me out. A little bit. Alright, in my head, I think I know how we're going to do the expansion. And we'll have a lot of wall frames. I had to think about what that was called. Because we have a lot of garage doors now, which is really good. If we can afford the honeycomb, I would like the stone honeycomb, the TC area with stone, to make us look poor. And then if we can afford it, which is the main reason why I'm hitting this, well, I'd like to metal the interior, but maybe project the cost of upkeep. Because remember, I'm one person and one furnace right now, so I need to have a good surplus of this. Or to make sense. Plus my stone supply is gonna be rather low. There's that twinkle. See how tiny that is? Gets bigger as the day goes on. Disappears at night. I might as well get it. Come on. My aim is terrible. Dirty burps. The The building will not take long. So if we add two more squares, we're looking at one, maybe two. I don't know how we want to do that airlock. Probably with a garage door. It is just me. Do I? Let's see. It would just be like one garage door then, wouldn't it? I don't know yet. Okay. The moment we've been waiting for it. The whole reason, the whole purpose of this episode is to do the expansion. We're finally there. Sort of. Let me just dump this. Let's get outside and let's get it. Spaghetti. I'm always thinking in terms of like, oh, we need... Did I recycle that wooden thing? Out of habit? I did. We totally could have used that. Oh my goodness. Okay. Well, I didn't mean to recycle my door locks. Of course I have it. Jeez. One door and two. Is that right? We'll probably end up picking out this wall so we can put up another garage door. Just so you know. You know what? I want to use all the garage doors. I don't want any of my boxes, is what I'm thinking. We can figure out what we're building. Let's get this done. I'm going to go out with, like... That should be enough to do what we're trying to do, I think. I'm going to put our tools away in case they get clapped, because I will not be paying attention. That's just how I roll. Remember, we're pretty poor still. Okay, we're gonna close this. Be quick about it. You know what, though? What if we did... Hold on. We could do a 2x3. What if we... I'm trying to think if we put this up... Oh, this is so dangerous. I got my door. Let me close this. This is stupid. Why am I doing that? We build it like this, maybe we stick a garage door here for expansion. We have the option. What if we just did it like that? Oh. Yeah. Okay. Change of plans. Not what I was intending on doing, but I think it'll work. Wait, will it? No. Yes? We stick it. This is a bad time to change my mind. Can we do it like that? Oh, gotta look around me. The paranoia is real. If we're gonna... I just changed this from a 2x2 to a 2x3. Or the potential for a 2x3. I think... Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. Wow. That was crazy. We'll do this. And we'll frame this. Yes. Yes, that's how we're gonna do it. I had to think. Yep, okay, we're free farming this one. I had to think about it for a second. Who's so rogue? Okay, I think we can deal with this. We can deal with this. Yep. Come on. Still not fast. I'm so used to using the mouse and keyboard on PC, so I'm like flicking and being like boop, 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 like speed building. I'll get there eventually with this, but. Okay, it's a little weird. Definitely expensive. We can stick garage doors on that. Alright, let's do the exterior first. I'm kind of sweaty. Do two. How many locks do we have? Not enough. Did I stick the other one in the box? I did. Do we have a regular metal door yet? We don't. Okay, I'm gonna make another one of these. And then a Sheet metal door, if I can afford it. Lag? Come on, come on, come on, come on. Ba-da-bip, ba-da-bip. Sheet metal door, gotta remember not to make the code lock, because that is definitely a force of habit. Put this back in case we get clapped. Let's load this up into our hotbar. I should maybe have a weapon on me when I'm doing this. This is sketchy. It is early morning on a work day, so I'm hoping that's going to be my saving grace. Sheet metal door is almost done. Alright, we're going to stick the rest of this inside. That's a weird configuration, but we'll get there. Definitely not what I thought we were going to do. But I was just kind of thinking as I was out there, I'm like, I think this will work if we do like this weird pseudo-expansion slot. Like, we're not going to open that garage door. We're going to use it as an expansion port or a socket for us to load up when we're good. And this will be our out. And then when this becomes our new exit and stuff, we're going to put like vending machines and stuff on there, which is kind of a hot move. We'll flip them, turn off the broadcast, and we'll use them as storage. We'll actually cover them up completely, which is also a very, very hot move. Okay. I think we did it. Somehow, some way, we did it. Go ahead and put our stuff down. Let's give it a nice little rundown. It only took us about an hour. Don't tell anyone. Yeah, not bad. Not bad. This gives us a lot more protection. We've got two garage doors. And we're going to put more sheet metal doors here when we can afford it. So two sheet metal doors, two garage doors. I'm sorry, three sheet metal doors and two garage doors to TC. Right now, hopefully people are confused as to where the TC is. This is a 2x2, but let's be honest, they'll probably think it's in the back corner. But hey, this will work for now. We're definitely a bit juicier. Our upkeep is what, 658? And 144 metal fragments, so we definitely something we can maintain. I think on the next episode, we're going to be doing some more upgrades to this and hopefully running some more bigger monuments, because we definitely need to get our scrap game up. There you go. That's our fourth day, or I should say the fourth episode of the solo series on the Rust Council Edition. Be sure to drop a like if you did enjoy yourself. If you think this is something you'd like to watch in the future, we'll be doing more of these types of series. We'll also be doing a lot of live streams, as we have been doing quite heavily. And yeah, hopefully we'll see you guys in the next video/live stream. Love you. Bye. Boop, boop, boop.